I saw him last week. He doesn't stay with me anymore. He moved out 3 days before Christmas.
And what did he say
about today? Oh, nothing about today. He was thinking about other things. I mean, you know, he's been under house arrest for like 540 days.
So what else? Did you make any plans? Or was he thinking about
plans? We didn't have that conversation. I mean, he's somebody who spends his time, you know, in his work. He's trying to run WikiLeaks. He's trying to make that organisation work under circumstances where he's been deliberately starved of cash. And so it's a struggle just to run that, I imagine. And so I think that's where his real efforts are.
So where is he staying now?
I'm not going to tell you because I wouldn't want what happened to us and the amount of press that arrived on our doorstep to arrive on anybody else.
Well, why is he not staying with you now?
Oh, because he'd stay with us for 13 months. But the intention, he never wanted to stay with us forever. I mean, he didn't want to overstay his welcome. He didn't. However, the court cases seem to go on and on and on. There's always a way to stay another 2 weeks, stay another 2 weeks. When he came to the Supreme Court, he realised that he was going to have to stay in Britain for several months. He then took the decision, he applied to the court to adjust his bail to stay somewhere else. Mainly because my wife, and you're having 4.5 months of son.
Congratulations.
Wife, clearly, he felt that she needed to stay.
Is it he?
Well, I don't think the court case takes any control on Julian and running with him, but he's a man of great courage and conviction. You know, he's not, you know, I know him better than probably any of you. You know, I don't recognise him when I see your reports about him. So, no, I mean, he's a man who I think that, you know, in a different age, at a different time, would elicit a different reaction. I think he thinks that there should be greater diplomatic support in Australia, but it's not something that he spends his time discussing. But he, you know, clearly a lot of Australians are very supportive of him, and I think they're right to him. I think they should be proud of him. No, I didn't say that. I didn't say that. I'm not going to comment on that. What I would say is that, you know, personally, I think Australians should be proud of what they have to him. And I think he recognises that. I know his mother is in as well. I know that she's been spending a lot of effort trying to support him. Yes, I think that Australia does have a responsibility to one of its citizens. I think we, I think we're just insufficiently tolerant.
Does he show any stress as if the time is running out, the time clock is ticking? Thank you very much.
being misled by a minister who misunderstood the real English meaning of a French word, which is, if you're English, that's kind of quite funny. I think, from what I know of Mr. Assange, he's always ready to fight wrong. He's somebody who stands up and fights what he believes in, and that's more of a shame. I don't know that. I don't know what his next steps legally are, because I'm not a lawyer. I'm a supporter. I'm not sure. He had no legal requirements for here. He wasn't legally obliged to be here at all. You know, whether he got stuck in traffic, I don't know. He doesn't stay with me, so I don't know whether he even wanted to come or whether or not. I don't.
Go ahead.